You mentioned the regeneration of the stem cells. So that's the study that you're referring to. You did this prolonged fasting for, I think it was like 48 to 72 hours in animals. And you showed that during that fasting state, the white blood cells were clear. They were basically, their populations decreased. And the reason they had decreased was because something was being activated called autophagy, which is the clearing away of damaged cells. And somehow, the autophagy that happened, you're saying that after that occurred, that was the signal for the regeneration of the stem cells, or
yeah,
refeeding after?
Autophagy is clearly occurring. This is established for fasting. But we don't think, what we've done so far was, now we're focusing more on autophagy, but what we've done so far, it was more about if you have an immune system, a complete immune system, that immune system has a lot of cells that you don't really need, right? Mm-hmm. So during starvation, whether you're a mouse, and now we know the same to be true for people, you have to get rid of a lot of cells, a lot of things that you don't need. And that's what's happening. It's not so much about autophagy, but it's more about apoptosis. And so programmed cell death. You're killing, essentially getting rid of a lot of cells. And then you stand by, you wait until food comes around again, and you rebuild it. So, for example, in a mouse, about 40% of the white blood cells are destroyed during this period of 4 days of fasting or so. And then that 40% is rebuilt within a few days of refeeding, right? So it's really extraordinary. And probably the most powerful regeneration or generation program that you have since birth, essentially, right? So when a baby is first born, of course, you're generating all these systems. But then that never happens again, right? Not in that way. Like, for example, the liver being generated and the lungs being generated and the heart, et cetera. So fasting is probably the most powerful, at least that we could think of, the most powerful way, particularly if it's prolonged, to shrink a system, let's say, make the liver a lot smaller, make all these organs a lot smaller, the immune system, and then regenerate it, right? And so this is why we think it's so powerful, because it's not really the fasting that is doing anything, it's the body that is doing everything. The fasting just tells the body, I need you to kill all the cells, and then the refeeding gives the message, I need you to rebuild all these systems.